Hey everyone, it's Claire from Cinemania, and today I'm going to be sharing my take on Scott Pilgrim. Now, you may have been thinking, oh, she's going to talk about the game. No. She's going to talk about the comics. No. Oh, she has to be gonna... She is going to talk about the new Netflix adaptation, the animated one. No. Wrong again. Although... it may be briefly mentioned in this video. We're actually going to be talking about the one and only 2010, released on August 13th, Scott Pilgrim vs. the World live action, starring your one and only Michael Cera as the lead himself, Scott Pilgrim. Look at him. That's him. Just kidding. That's not him. That is Jesse Eisenberg, because this is Michael Cera. That is Michael Cera. You might know him from his various roles. I don't know, like Juno, Superbad, or his most recent one, Alan from the Barbie movie with Margot Robbie, directed by Greta Gerwig. But we're not talking about the Barbie movie. We're talking about Scott Pilgrim. Joined by his co-star, Mary Elizabeth Winstead, this lovely woman right here. You might know her from the Final Destination franchise. I'm pretty sure she was in all the movies. I may be wrong. But then again, we're not talking about her. We're talking about Michael motherfucking Cera. There is a very packed, loaded cast in this movie, including my deadpan queen, Aubrey Plaza. Yes, this woman right here, lovely. You might know her from Parks and Rec. You might know her from SNL. I don't know. She's pretty famous. I'm not gonna lie to you. And... there's also this handsome fellow. You might know him. He has a very famous brother. And no, I'm not talking about the one on the right. Although that is another famous brother. That is Rory Culkin. Might sound familiar. You know Macaulay Culkin? Yeah. Home Alone kid. But we're not talking about either of them. We're talking about the one and only Kieran Culkin. The Wallace Wells. And maybe you've heard that name before, maybe because you've watched Scott Pilgrim, or maybe you've been on TikTok recently and you have seen this one specific edit. Show the clip.
He's in love with me, isn't he? Mm-hmm.
And if you haven't seen that edit, maybe you saw this one instead.
I think at one point I was like, could you pull up your pants a bit? It's really difficult to listen to this story.
Tipping in my convo, bubbles in my champagne, let it be some jazz playing.
Top floor motel.
Yeah. Enough said, right? He's been on things such as Succession. I don't know. But he is... pretty well known amongst his brothers. And he is going to be one of the best parts of this movie. And as I said, this cast is pretty packed with some well-known faces. We have one superhero, another superhero, this guy. Just kidding. It's actually this guy. They are not the same person. This girl from AHS. This guy, who's another superhero. This girl, nope, not the one on the left, the one on the right. And this guy from this clip with Taylor Swift, he's from New Girl.
Will you take me away from this madness? And you are not too short for me, I don't care what your mother says.
And this girl, you might know her, this is her voice.
Water. Earth. Fire. Air.
And that's the face behind the voice. And finally, this pink thing. Now that we've got the important parts of the cast out of the way, this movie, as I said, released on August 13th, 2010. I was like 3 years old when it came out, but that's besides the point. It was directed by this guy, Edgar Wright, not the direction Wright, even though he is a director. I'm hilarious. No, director Wright as in playwright. And he, you know, directed things like Baby Driver and Shaun of the Dead and one of the greatest movies I've ever watched, Hot Fuzz. If you haven't watched it, go watch it. But we're not talking about Hot Fuzz, are we? We're talking about Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. Let's get into it. Okay, everyone, fair warning, do not take this video for research purposes. This is a entertainment video only. This video is explicitly for entertainment. Thank you very much. Now, if you don't know what Scott Pilgrim is about, quick synopsis, the main guy, Scott Pilgrim, lives with his roommate, and he is dating a high schooler, and all of a sudden, one day, girl with pink hair shows up in his dream and he can't get her out of his head, and you know, he tries to, you know, do a little rizzy and rizz her up, and he's somewhat successful, but apparently he has to go through her 7 evil exes and fight for her hand in marriage or whatever. And basically it's a journey of self-discovery, and at the end of the movie, you know, everyone realizes that, oh, everyone is a douchebag, everyone is an asshole, but it's okay because we can redeem ourselves if we just put our minds to it, yada yada yada. That's basically it, and I'm here to just criticize the hell out of this movie, so let's go. As you can see, the very first thing you see is a universal opening motif to the game itself.
Please be good.
Am I normally not?
Hey Knives, this is Steven Stills. He's the talent.
Yes, because we all know Steven Stills is the talent, and I love the casting for this movie. Steven Stills, chef's kiss. I love this man. I'm so glad that his sister actually talked some sense into this man, although he doesn't take it, but I'm so glad that she says something, because why is Steven Stills in and young Neil like, oh yeah, she's so cool, like I'm so happy for you, Michael Cera, what? Okay, this scene is foreshadowing a very important scene in the very end of the movie. Spoilers, it's, you know, like the final battle scene, and it's just, like, super, super sick, and this whole, like, thing in the arcade, it's, like, you know, referencing the game again, and then referencing, like, what's going to happen in the movie. You know, he's gonna be fighting 7 evil exes, yada, 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 but, like, specifically, this part is referencing the very last battle where he, has to like go up against Gideon Gray and that guy, and he has to fight with Knives, and it's so sick, and it's sick.
Pay for this, flowers. If you want to fight me,
what?
You're not the brightest. You won't know what's hit you.
This scene with Matthew Mattel is the funniest thing I've ever watched. The way he just automatically starts breaking out in song and dance is so funny to me. And I don't know if you've been on TikTok and you've seen the videos, but like this, the audio of this like scene with him singing has been going around, and every single time it never fails. It never fails to crack me up. It's actually a problem. It's actually a problem. But Matthew Mattel, this guy in this movie, he has a very short screen time in this movie, but gosh, he makes it worthwhile. We all know that in this scene where they're riding the bus on Ramona's side, the lights in the back are X's to represent, oh, she's like closed off, oh, and also her 7 evil X's, yada yada yada. And on Scott's side, you know, all the lights are hearts in the background, and eventually, once Ramona starts opening up, the hearts appear on her side too. We all know that. And I'm just here to remind you guys. I like how Michael Cera is literally the scrawniest guy ever, and he's going up against not one, not two, but literally several stunt doubles for Chris Evans. And he manages to beat them all. Guys, what What? I know if you've never watched this movie, you might be so confused. And honestly, when I first watched this movie, I was so confused. But then after rewatching it several times, I'm like, okay, it might not make sense. But at the same time, it makes so much sense. It makes so much sense. And I'm not even going to explain it to you because you should just get it. The girls who get it. And the girls who don't. This whole movie, I literally, Knives is my Roman Empire. Knives is my Roman Empire. I love her so much. And the fact that she just loves this scrawny white boy is insane to me. Insane. She's obsessed. He has groomed her to the point she is stalking his ass. That's crazy. This is Michael Cera, guys. Michael Cera. Unbelievable. Envy freaking Adams. Now, a lot of people have watched this and they're like, what happened to Brie Larson? Why does she look like this now? Guys, she looks exactly the same. She literally looks exactly the same, just a little more mature. And Brie Larson in this movie, I know, she's fire. And this scene, fire. But, you know, people grow up. And this was in 2010. It is 13 years later, and I need everyone else to grow up. Because this scene, iconic. I love me some Envy Adams. Even though in the game, in the comics, in the adaptation from Netflix, she has red hair. In this movie, she has blonde hair. I think the blonde hair was actually a great choice. A great choice on Brie. Amazing. Okay, guys. When it comes to the vegan police is actually the realest thing ever. Because I always thought, like, oh my god, the vegan police are real. Ever since I watched this movie, I was like, the vegan police have to be real. Because, like, who is keeping these vegans in check? Who is keeping these diehard vegans in check? Literally, you eat one little cube of cheese, you're gonna go to vegan jail, okay? It should be that way always. Okay, this battle between the twins and Sex Bob-omb. First of all, the twins are literally, what are they doing? They're pressing two buttons and they have dragons? What? Sex Bob-omb is literally playing real instruments. I mean, the twins are playing like the keyboard, the electric keyboard, and they're like DJing at the same time. And their music sucks. So I don't even know how they could be remotely even close to winning this battle. I don't understand it. Look at them. I don't know, but I'm so glad they lost. I love Anna Kendrick in this movie. Chef's kiss. I like how it goes from, oh, the power of love, and then it was like, oh, the power of self-esteem. Yes, Scott Pilgrim. You go, Scott Pilgrim. Let's go, Scott Pilgrim. And then everyone gets closure. Kim gets closure. Young Neil gets closure. Steven gets closure. You know, Ramona, she's getting there. And Scott is finding himself along the way. And it's an amazing journey. And Gideon Graves is dead. He's D-E-A-D, dead. And that's my take on this. A short memoir for the friends we lost along the way. And that's a wrap. That's been my take. And that's a wrap. That's been my take on Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. This was Claire from Cinemania. See you in the next video.